Good afternoon, so I'm here with my Schofield revolver here, single action, and I did an unboxing review and chrome test a few days ago, and I'm going to do some pellet shooting. These are Superfield pellets, 8.4 grain, and these have the 4.52 millimeter head. You can get them in 4.51 and 4.50, so this should actually fit the actual smoothbore barrel better. So we've loaded up. So what we've got, right, I've got a target at, we're going to use yards today, so I've got had my MGC rangefinder out, so we've got 10 yard target there, 12 and a half paper target there, 6 cannons at 12 and a half yards, a man to shoot at, and we're going to put 6 in the head and 6 in the body at 15 yards, we've got 2 cannons at 15 yards beside it. And then out, we've got a pyramid of 3 cannons at 20 yards, okay? Or they're just over 20 yards, 20.5 yards, according to my rangefinder. Okay, so what we're going to do, we'll do some freestanding, all freestanding shots after your single action, get single action revolver, as you know. I'm going to take 6 shots at that paper target and 6 at the other paper target so you can see the action. I'm going to use 2 hands because I'm not comfortable shooting this one-handed yet, unlike the single-action Colt. Probably will do eventually. And then we're going to zoom in on the cannons and zoom in on the targets, okay? So here we go. So 6 shots first at the 10-yard target. Single-action. Here we go, and see how accurate this thing is. Excuse me, my head is playing up when I stretch out, but we'll see how we do. We get them pretty central. Try and keep still. Right, that's 6 shots there. So we'll open it up. Pop 6 more pellets in the top, and what we'll do when I've taken the other paper target, we'll bring the paper targets up, and then the other targets will pause the video, between reloads, because it will save some time on the video. We don't want it being too long. We don't want you people getting bored, falling asleep, you know, that sort of thing. Of course, I'm only kidding. Well, maybe I'm not. Okay, so we close that back up again. I'm ready to go. So we're going to go up and take 6 shots at the 12 and a half metre paper target. Again, freestanding. Right, so that's 6 shots. We are definitely empty. Okay, so I'm going to bring those paper targets up. We'll have a close look. Right, so the 6 shots at 10 yards, you'll see they're nicely grouped. Yeah, got a group around here. That's freestanding. If you shot this off a bag, I'm pretty sure you'd get a tighter group. Don't forget, when I was shooting that cannon during the unboxing review at 12 and a half metres, I was also doing freestanding through the crony as well. So that's the sort of group. You'd probably get a tighter group, obviously, but that's pretty good. That's like an inch. Probably an inch group, probably, with those 5. Yeah, 1.5 with that one. At 12 and a half, I was moving around a bit at 12 and a half yards. But you can see you've got 4, 5, all in a line sort of thing. So, yeah, it looks like it could be shooting slightly to the left. Okay, but we'll see. And obviously one I think I moved just too much for that one and pulled it up the top. So that's pretty good. So what we're going to do now, we're going to pause the video, I'll reload, and we're going to go for the cans, the six cans, pyramid, and then we'll take the man target at 15 yards, the two cans, and the actual three at 20 metres. We'll probably do them in one video, okay? So I'll be back shortly. Good afternoon, so I'm back with my Schofield single action revolver, and I've got six cans there at 12 and a half yards, so I'm just going to zoom in. And I'm going to try and knock them down from top to bottom. I'm going to shoot this pretty quickly. I'm trying to keep the video reasonably short. I've got a lot of targets to go through. But here goes. Oh, that pulled that one. That was me. Yep, pretty good. So that's six shots, no problem whatsoever. So yeah, that one I missed, that was purely me. Obviously my breathing, my hernia, just moved a little bit, obviously with a revolver freestanding at 12 and a half yards. Don't forget this is a smooth bore revolver, so that's the thing, you know, there's no rifling in there. So that's pretty good for smooth bore with a pellet. And so what we'll do, we'll pause this, I'll reload, and then we'll move on to the actual man. And I think we'll zoom in on that and we'll take six shots, or maybe three shots of the head and three shots of the body, and see how they do. Okay, be back shortly. So I'm back with my Schofield single action revolver here, and I've got a man out there at 15 yards. I'm going to zoom in onto his head, I'm going to take three shots of his head, and pan down to the actual body and take three shots of the body. And see how we do. So here we go, there's obviously be freestanding again, 15 yards out with good old iron sights, as these wonderful revolvers came with. There we go. Let's see if we should be able to see these pellets going in. Got a rough idea where to aim, but here goes. Okay, and then we'll pan down to the body, like so, and see where the next three go. Okay, so shot them pretty quickly. So what we'll do, we'll review that, but I'm pretty sure the body shots are reasonably close in the center. And so we'll pause the video, reload, and then we'll go to the cans, the two at 15 yards and the three pyramid at 20 yards. Be back shortly. So I'm back with my Schofield single action revolver. I've got two cans at 15 yards and three cans in a pyramid at 20 yards. I've got six shots, so what I'm going to do is try and knock them down. The wind's got up a bit, see the flag flying down the bottom, and also the temperature's only 14 degrees, so it's cooled down quite a bit. I can feel the CO2 cooling on the grip as well, so we're going to zoom in. I've got a rough idea where to aim for the 15 yards, because I'm just doing the 15 yard man. The target's out at 20 yards, yeah, we're going to try and get them as well. So here goes, we'll give me one spare shot if I pull one. So here goes, again freestanding. Right, now the 20 yard ones. Oh, I think I might have hit the bottom one actually. So I could have been that far away. Let's see if we get the other one. I've clipped it. I've nudged it again. I think I might have one shot left. So let's do a knock it over. Yeah, got it. Good afternoon. So I'm here with my Schofield revolver and I've got a bit of additional video. I'm going to try and knock six cans down at 20 yards. Obviously single action, this is a single action revolver. Freestanding. I'm going to use both hands to support this because I haven't really shot, I'm not going to shoot this single action if I get used to it like I can with the single action. Colt, so there we go. I've got a rough idea where to aim, so here goes. See if I can get them all. Trigger is really nice on this. There's a little bit of creep before it breaks, but it's very consistent. Sights are pretty good. If you can keep still, you should be able to hit them. Oh, okay. that wasn't the plan. So we can get the other ones. I think I moved a bit there. I clipped it. Definitely clipped it. I heard it clip it. Again, I'm struggling to keep still with my breathing, my hernia. Yep, yeah. Aim point is just below the top of the can. Clipped it again. Two clips, I'm out. So there you go, that's 20 yards out with a smoothbore revolver using RWS Superfields with the 4.52mm head. These weigh 8.4 grain, by the way. That's pretty good. I mean, I was really struggling with my hernia, outstretched, it tightens up, and I really struggled to keep her still. It is quite gusty now, the wind's starting to get up, it's only 14 degrees C, but I actually hit three cleanly, I think, and the one I knocked the bottom off, and the other two, I think, definitely clipped the cans. I heard them clip the cans. So I was only probably a fraction, about half a 5-10 millimeters out probably with them, yeah, from hitting the dead center of the can. So there you go. So for a smooth bore revolver, this is really fantastic. Funnily enough, I was talking about the SA, the single action Colt, which I also have a 5.5-inch pellet version, fully rifled barrel, and I have actually shot it out to 20 yards. I was looking at that the other day, so I might do comparison between this and the 5.5-inch single action revolver pellet version, and use the same pellet and see if I can actually take out a pyramid at 20 yards. And I might even try one-handed as well, which could be interesting. So I hope you like that little video. This is a worthwhile addition. Definitely, if you like your classic, revolvers, really really nice. I'm really impressed with this. So I hope you like that. Hope you like that video. Thanks for watching.